Hey everyone, this is a set called the Scuttler, a giant four-legged walking mech thing from the Lego Batman movie. Look at this thing. It's really different. It really stands out. It looks to me, excuse me for crossing brands, but it looks to me like something that would have come from Zoids. Like if Zoids had done a Lego Bat thing, it would have been this. It would have been exactly this. Interesting that they're going for a bat that walks, or in its walking form. This does not transform into a flying form, I'll tell you that right now. What you see is mostly what you get, but it does have some interesting features. I think the most important thing to show you first is articulation, because it is a walking thing after all, so it needs to be able to walk, it needs to be able to move legs around. Those move, those rotate. They're stiff ratcheted joints, so they're nice and strong. You can bring the front legs up. It's not able to stand on three legs, I'm afraid, but it does have this very important dab action, realistic dab action. So if I can get this to work with just two hands, come on, there we go. We have made contact. We have made success. This is it. Okay, end of review. There you go. That's it. So, yeah. Each of these front legs moves in and out. Really does not like to be on three legs. Keep it on all four, and it'll be all good. You can actually extend these out to raise up the front quite a lot. And then I'll get the back on the ground. That's about as tall as it'll get right there. And relative to the height of a minifig, there you go. See, it's pretty impressive size-wise. And then you can also get it down to the ground. Even with the front legs extended out like this, you can bring it down pretty close to the ground. I can bring these legs back. Maybe do something like this. It kind of walks on its toes at the rear like that, but so you can get it pretty far, pretty close to the ground, and the front legs kind of spread out like that, which is kind of funky, but it's interesting. The head is done pretty well, and also has articulation. It can also rotate around. So first of all, up and down, good range there, and also can twist this way to kind of look like huh. And this is also very important, has ears that can be moved back, so you can use dog emotions with it. It can be sad and embarrassed like that, more alert like that. See, all that works. Stud shooters on the sides, so one on each side. I like this use of this canopy piece that they use way too much in helicopters in Lego City. Here it works great. It's actually upside down. Or 90 degrees off. 270 degrees off. Something like that. This is a nice cockpit built up. Look at this. I can actually rotate it towards you so that you can see it better. And this is just a panel in the front. No print or, you know, sticker there. But if I take Batman out, there are a couple stickers on the sides. So, you know, has some buttons to push there, and display over here, you know, systems check and such. You can bring these out if you want to get a little bit easier access in there, but I think it works best just leaving them in. Everything comes together nicely. These front legs obviously need to be strong and sturdy, which they are, but they're pretty well covered up. They do use clear backed stickers in this set, unfortunately, not black backed stickers, so it's difficult to get everything to be nice and smooth beneath there. There's some air under there that burnishing just didn't take out. Maybe a little bit more work will help with that, but I'm kind of hanging around this area because I want to point out the inclusion of the long tile here. It's an 8 long tile, which is covering up some very ugly stuff behind there, which in many sets I've complained they've just left exposed. Like Technic pieces, Technic, you know, brick pieces that have lots of holes or pins sticking out. So if the Lego designer happens to be watching this video, thank you for putting that tile on there. I know it uses up pieces that are probably needed for other parts of the build that you want to be able to use, but It looks so much better covering up all that ugly stuff. Two stud shooters on each of these front arms or legs. These are supposed to be like lights, so you can, you know, angle those up. There's some more lights on the sides of the cockpit as well. No coverage for the side of the Technic brick here because that actually needs to go down into the channel that's involved with the leg extension action. There's no knob or anything that you turn to make that happen. You just pull the leg out, you know, push it in, which is fine. I have no problems with that whatsoever. Here's another action feature up here. It's a net shooter, and you know, I've not had great success with the use of these. This cannot be angled up and down. It can only be turned side to side, but the general idea is you push on this black plain astromech head on the back and out comes a net. And depending upon your luck and how well you folded it up, maybe you can actually catch something with that. Around the back, okay, so there's let me get to these back legs quickly first, just so that you can have a good understanding of how they're built with the large ratcheted pieces. You know, this is really pretty straightforward stuff, but it's pretty effective. There are a lot of stickers in this set. If you hate stickers, you're especially going to hate this one. It's especially big. And again, clear backed, and in this case, going against a transparent part means you're going to see the bubbles under there. So just maximize your technique. Maybe practice a little bit in advance. Move the net shooter out of the way. Open all this up. Caution, hot contents. Open all this up. That's an engine. That's cool. I like it. I like it a lot. That exhaust port is huge, but that's okay. I think, there you go. Rotate that around something. Rotate it like this. This thing. This actually is removable, and this is a jetpack for Batman. So, take our caped crusader here. Uh-oh. There you go. Just put him in place, and he can go flying off. Now, these engines are on ball joints, which I think would be really good for stop-motion animators, because they can kind of show, you know, how these would move independently while you're in flight. But all told, this is a pretty straightforward thing, especially given that he just stands on it. A couple of searchlights in the front, and that's that. And when you take that out, it leaves a bunch of space back here, like a cargo bay. So if you want to leave that out and just let this be space for stuff to be put in there, or people, you can put several figures back there. Use it as a jail area, temporary, you know, holding cell if you catch a villain or two. So that's good. Looking at the minifigs in this set, here are the protagonists first. Of course, Batman and Dick Grayson Robin here. This is Commissioner Gordon, and this is Barbara Gordon, the daughter. I think that Robin kind of steals the show here. I mean, Dick Grayson steals the show here with the dark blue color of the actual physical bow tie piece and the glitter. He's got the glitter on the jacket, goes all the way around. He's looking pretty fabulous. Really trying to steal the show here, I think. However, Commissioner Gordon also has that great print on the arm there. That looks pretty sweet to me. Got print on the other arm as well. Barbara Gordon has the dual molded arms. However, there is a surprise once I start taking some stuff off. Batman is actually Angry Clone from Star Wars. Okay, I'm kidding. He's actually Creepy Clone from Star Wars. No, there's the real Batman face under there. Well, one of them. But the true surprise to me was the lack of any print on the torso for Barbara Gordon there, because, you know, she's got the GCPD print on the vest, which looks fine, but to have absolutely no print is just a surprise to me. I don't think it needs a print. There are the alternate faces. I don't think it needs a print whatsoever, because you're always going to have the vest on, or most of the time you're going to have the vest on. You know, this is a tactical outfit that she's wearing here, but it just surprised me personally. Only two baddies in this set, but they're goodies, if you catch my drift. I think they're both good figures, both good characters to have. Super long tails coming off the coat for the Joker over here. That's just one single cloth piece, and because it's synthetic and the with the particular material that they used, you can bend it and get it to just stay like that, which is cool. Only comes from the hips down, you know, it doesn't extend all the way through the whole thing, but it's a pretty good look. And the instructions for this set do have the proper orientation specified for the bang stickers on the joke gun there. Poison Ivy looks very different in the face with what they've done with the eye makeup for, almost looks like they went for a different visual style, but if you look at it carefully, you know, the eyes are just standard modern Lego eyes, but you know, what they've done with the makeup is something a wee bit different. And then she does have a couple of these vines, and there are more as well. I'll show you in just a minute. But this is a nice hairpiece, headgear piece, which has just a paint application there on the side for the white rose. Good printing on the side of the arm there. Just continues the pattern from the front of her outfit, just continues that right on through. The arms are also dual molded. And as for alternate faces, you do get one for each, which is good. And I wouldn't be surprised if a lot of folks actually used the back of Poison Ivy as the front. Just saying. Here are the rest of the vines that I mentioned for her. They just create a vine beast mount thing that she can walk around with. And, you know, there's obviously plenty of articulation available with this because you can turn these up and down. You can also rotate them around and, you know, get different looks. So another thing that I think will be pretty good for the stop motion folks out there. Clear stand included. Yep. A couple pieces used under there just to make it always stable so that if you're playing with this, you're messing around with it and you get everything out of whack. So the legs are all over the place and then you want to bring them back down to the ground, just push them down to the ground and everything will just line up, you know, as opposed to not having that cheater clear piece underneath there, which would require you to align everything carefully. Just push them down and I think that works out very nicely. I think the minifig selection in this set is great in its quantity and quality, but for me what really tugs at my heartstrings is the overall visual impact of this Scuttler. I think that for once they've actually made the set look worse on the box than it is in real life. I'm definitely far more impressed with it now than I was before because it's much larger than I expected it to be. We've got Batman actually beneath the thing there, so it's, you know, giving you a fair assessment of its size and scale relatively speaking. And obviously the black is just very striking, but you know, little details that they've put into shaping things really pay off. You know, it feels like it has a good level of finish to it, and they did, you know, cover up a lot of the bad and ugly stuff, but not all. There are some blue Technic pin, axle pin pieces that are showing through. I think that front of the rear hip area is one of the more ugly parts of the whole thing. And you do get to see that Technic brick from the side on either side, which is pretty obvious for the legs. Not huge issues, but things that I personally do not like. Well played, Lego. Well played. See, look on the box. They have it down so low so that it ends up being wider, you know, to go better with this landscape shape of the box. But yeah, this really doesn't show you how large it can truly be. I guess I should have had it on its toes the whole time, but it just felt more secure to have it on the pads. But yeah, all told, a very nice set, really nice mech, very inspiring to me. You know, I think that's a really good sign, you know, when it just motivates me, makes me want to build things. It just means that I really, really deeply like what I'm looking at. And, you know, it plays fine and definitely comes with a good selection of minifigs that a lot of folks are gonna want. So I just feel like they have a success here. They have a winner. Let me know what you think. As always, your feedback is appreciated, not just by and for me, but also by and for other viewers. Folks like to talk to other folks of like minds and folks with different opinions, you know, thinking of things from different perspectives. Sometimes it brings out stuff that you didn't even realize. So thanks in advance for your feedback. Thank you for watching. And if you want to see more videos from me, be sure to check back on my channel on a regular basis, because YouTube really likes to unsubscribe people for no reason. And even if you are subscribed, YouTube doesn't like to let you know when new content comes out on the channels that you are subscribed to. So outsmart YouTube, check the channel yourself manually, and you'll see new stuff all the time. Catch you later.